I'm here with Nancy Friesen. She is our administrator, and she does a number of other things as well. It's just administration, and I'm at her house right now. And so, Nancy, can you tell our listeners just a little bit of what an ordinary day's work is for you here in Gloria on the mission field?
I guess it depends on what day it is, because half my time is spent as an English teacher at school, and half my time is spent as administrator of MEM. So as the administrator, I take care of the financial pay invoices, documentations, visas for the MEM members, financial statements that go out to Canada, just the day-to-day administration for the mission.
So when you, all these visas that we, mm-hmm. when new missionaries come, I know that it's a lot of work, and especially in Bolivia, they have so much red tape that you have to go through. So tell me a little bit about that experience. How does it go for you?
It can get quite frustrating. Many, many trips to Santa Cruz, and some days you come back and you get nothing done. And then when you get something done, I just got my driver's license a couple of days ago, and it's a thrilling experience when you finally get it done.
Finally get something done. Tell me a little bit about in the school. It's not only that you teach, but you're also a part of the school board. Tell me a little bit about that.
Yeah, I'm the treasurer of the school board, and so I take care of all the finances at the Villanueva school as well. Invoices, if Trudy, the secretary, needs anything, I pass on funds from MEM to the school. Part of my duties is also to collect funds from the tuition, from families paying tuition. So yeah, we're just starting a new school year, and so we had to hire 9 new teachers, and so we've been busy interviewing and figuring out the schedule and planning the new school year.
So I take it this time of the year, even though there is no school right now, but it's still a very, very busy time for you to get the school organized, am I right?
Correct. I spent all morning and afternoon there. We were registering all new students, and I'll be spending all day there again tomorrow registering new students. And so yes, it's actually, even though there's no classes, it's busier than ever.
So can you tell us approximately how many students you're going to be having this coming year?
We're planning on 170 to 175 students. We had 190 students last year, and we had 9 graduates, so one of the biggest graduating classes we've ever had. And there's a couple of families that moved off to Canada, so we're planning on about 175 students this year.
So how many students, approximately brand new students, that are coming into the school? Because I understand that many of the newer students, they may not know Spanish, they know Polish. Are there quite a few of those?
Yes, last year we had 30 new students, and most of them were directly off the colony, so very little education and less Polish. And so, yeah. This year we're not quite sure yet, because our registration isn't done yet, but we're expecting quite a few again this year.
Well, that's good. It's nice to hear that. Mm-hmm. We're sitting in your house, and you have a brand new house that has got built not that long ago. Nancy, how long have you been living in your new house?
Since July of last year, so 6 months.
Well, I see that's a very beautiful house, and I'll just pan around a little bit, and I'll show our audience a little bit what your new house looks like. And so she has a nice little kitchen there, and so I'll just make one circle here. There's a feature wall and a little bit of a living space, so you can see that she lives quite nice. She lives quite comfortable here.
Yes, I'm very comfortable.
Praise the Lord.
Mm-hmm. Yes, absolutely.